A little politics in our pop culture lead today when President Trump called African countries S-holes and said he did not want people from Haiti immigrating to the U.S. He sparked outrage from not only nations around the world, but also from late-night talk show host Conan O'Brien, who decided to film a special in Haiti to showcase its natural beauty and its people. Joining me now is the host of TBS's Conan, Conan O'Brien. Thanks for being here, Conan.
Thanks for having me, Jake.
So you let some Haitians take a jab back at President Trump. Let's take a quick listen.
Tant pis, viens visiter Haïti. Parce que chaque fois où quitter pays, c'est les États-Unis viennent bon.
Nous avons un pile bel terrain golf, monsieur le président. Viens jouer là, là où vous voulez faire coquet.
Moi, je voulais voir un message d'amour pour chef États-Unis. Oprah, nous aimons.
But more seriously, how did you find Haitians reacted to the president's comments?
You know, it's interesting. I encountered the same thing that I encountered when we took our show to Mexico City last year, which is that there are human beings. They get their feelings hurt. And I think when you go there and you meet the people, though, that you find out that, yeah, they're sensitive. And when they hear comments like that, they're upset by them. The Haitians are a very strong people with a lot of dignity, and they have a lot of resilience, obviously, so they bounce back. But you could sense that they wanted to talk. They wanted to tell, they wanted to react, and they wanted a forum. And they wanted to be able to show that there's a lot of positive things about Haiti that never get much media attention. So we gave them a chance to do that.
And they also seemed that they wanted to talk about and educate the American people as to part of the reason why Haiti isn't the best Haiti it could be, because of a century worth of colonization and exploitation by France and then the United States.
Yes, they've Haiti, as we say in the special, has been dealt one of the worst hands in the Western Hemisphere. It's a beautiful country, and it is a country that has an amazing people. They have an incredible, they're artists, they have a great sense of humor, they have incredible talent, and their country's been exploited. We've done a lot of damage to Haiti, and so have the other countries that colonized them. And they've been robbed of a lot of their riches. And so I spoke to children in Haiti who said, oh, you're from the United States, you're here to take stuff from us. And I had to assure them that, no, I'm not going to do that, and that maybe more Americans are going to be willing to give some stuff back to Haiti and help out a little bit.
Now, you've done 8 of these international adventure shows in 3 years in places such as Cuba and Israel. Tell us what might be different about this episode, given the current political climate.
You know, this is the fastest episode we've turned around. Usually, we have a little more time to plan these episodes. The president's comments came out on a Thursday night. I decided on a Saturday, let's go to Haiti. Sunday, we announced it, and then we left on Wednesday, and we were back the following Sunday, and we turned this around in just a few days. And so this is the fastest we've ever done a show. So that's very quick. The other thing that makes Haiti very different from a lot of the places I've been is there are a lot of countries that have problems. And in our last special, when I was in the Middle East, I looked into the Syrian border, and they have so many intractable problems in Syria, countries that are torn apart. What's incredible about Haiti is the problems seem fixable. I think there's a lot of, they need some infrastructure, they need some help, and they insist they can do it on their own. But, you know, you look at Haiti and you think this country could be very different in 20 years because the people are there, the natural resources are there, the beauty is there. Haiti can be much better off very quickly, I believe.
People ask me all the time, what's the biggest challenge being a journalist in the age of Trump? What's the biggest challenge being a comedian in the age of Trump?
Comedians usually in a normal era are supposed to take these sort of serious situations and find the comedy in them and stretch them a little bit. In the Trump era, we're essentially dealing with, I mean, every day there is such a motherload of, I don't know how else to say it, surreal news, that it can be very hard to find a joke that's more absurd than what's actually happening. Do you know what I mean? It's very hard to take what's really happening right now and make it somehow more absurd than it really is. So It's a challenge for comics. People think it's easy, but it's actually a little more difficult, I think, right now.
Yeah, the president works broad. He does a lot of broad work.
He does a lot of, you know, he works blue. he works broad. Blue. And just trying to keep up with him. I mean, that's the other thing is, for any other president, the S-hole comment would have resonated for a couple of weeks. He's on a two-day cycle. It's very hard to keep up with him.
Conan
it's
O'Brien,
exhausting.
Thank you so much. Conan
Thanks
Without Borders, Haiti, will premiere this Saturday on TBS at 10 p.m. Eastern. Thanks, Conan. Appreciate it.